super excited today to be able to announce this officially. You've heard me playing this. It's what has been driving a lot of the synth sounds on my board, but this is the new Dub Terrania from Iron Ether, one of my favorite pedal companies in the world. It has an octasynth, a unisynth, an octaver in it. It's got, you can use it just as an octaver. You can add the synths, bypass the synths. It's got triangle wave, square wave, different ranges. It has so many things, I don't even know what they all do yet. I've been messing with it for the last few weeks, as you have heard on my board, but it's been taped out or blacked out because it was a secret pedal. It was in beta testing. Me and a few very fortunate people, I believe Zach Reiser, whose pedal videos you have probably seen on YouTube, was also a beta tester on this one, as we both were, I think, on the FM Aaron, and he has been for many iterations of these pedals, the Iron Ether stuff. Anyway, long story long. It's been a secret. I've only just got to it. I'm way too late to the party, but it found a place on my board, and Taylor got in touch and said, okay, you know what? There is a batch of them about to be ready and about to launch, so you can tell people what it is and take the tape off. So here it is. I will, of course, do a full video dedicated to this pedal when it comes out, probably when I get back from Europe. And if I just plug it back in, see, now it's all kind of jammed into the board. I just had to take it off. I don't have a showroom model, so to speak, where I can just hang on a second. I gotta get this right. The sends and returns. Return goes to the bum 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 bum. Okay. Alright, that should be good. It should be back up and running on the board now. So I can give you a little audio sample now. Just a little teaser, if you haven't heard a previous episode where I'm using it. It's such a badass pedal. It really rivals, I think, albeit without presets and stuff, it really rivals stuff like the Future Impact and other kind of very well-known synth-based pedals that are out there at the moment. Let's see, where do I have it? I think I have it. Woo! Here we go. Oh my God, so good. Let's see what I have. Okay, so we've got all these different colors. Really robust, I think that's the first word that comes to mind. As are all the Iron Ether pedals. We could switch to some triangle wave here. And then... Woo! Really nice octave vibe in there as well. Different range. Let's see, in a combination. But anyway, there are so many things you can do with it. I haven't even begun to really figure it all out, and I am not doing it justice at all in this short demo. But those are just a few of the things it does. And also, I have it programmed here where I have the, also by Iron Ether, the Zero Graph Deluxe. Oh, that's really blowing out the mic. I know, I'm sorry about that, because once you get down in those low frequencies, my little Zoom H6 says, I don't think so. So, let me get back to my little scene over here. Anyway, yeah, so new pedal from Iron Ether, super psyched to be able to talk about that. Now, I am cramming. It's Tuesday, about 9 p.m. I'm leaving Thursday morning about 5 a.m. So I have maybe one more, half a day basically, because I got to do laundry and pack and do all that kind of stuff tomorrow before I leave for Canada. I was expecting just to be playing, was really happy to be going to Canada to play with Benny Greb, which of course I still am. And you've heard me checking out that music and relearning it and rebooting that partition of my brain. Now, at the very last second, as in 6 o'clock yesterday morning, Steve Smith, drummer of Journey and Vital Information, you guys all know who Steve Smith is, I'm sure, called me at the last minute because their bass player had to bail on their tour and he needed a replacement. He actually asked me to do the whole tour. I can't do it because obviously I'm going to Europe with Bobby, but I could do that. He's playing at the Drumeo Drum Festival, so I'm going to fill in there for one show. Super fun. I mean, I wish it was under better circumstances and speedy recovery to their bass player, of course, but really just happy to be able to help out and psyched to learn all this music. And boy, oh boy, is it a lot of notes. Woo! So, of course, the first thing he sends me is something in 13. I've got it right here. I even printed out the music so I could see it. 8 and 5. You may have seen Steve's performance on VF Jams, the Vic Firth thing that they've been doing on YouTube. I'm actually going to dial that up because that is the exact arrangement we are playing of that song. And I've just been jamming and jamming and jamming to it as much as I could. I mean, since yesterday, I got this music yesterday lunchtime. Had about half a day. I kind of learned most of it yesterday, I have to say. Steve Smith VF Jams. Here we go. This video has 151,000 views. About 142,000 of them are mine. Let's get a little juice on that and see how I do activating my reading chops. There are a couple of things. I'm actually going to turn down the sensitivity on the mic because I'm probably blowing it out. Sorry, guys. This is all very thrown together at the moment. There are a couple of things. I got to pull up the email here from Steve because there were a couple of mistakes on the chart in terms of the form that I have to adjust. Anyway, let me see if I can dive back in. Thank you. Okay. Couple of scuffs. Oh, fun to be reading again, gotta say. Really looking forward to playing this with Steve. Of course, it will not be under such controlled, not be in such a controlled environment as this, sitting here with my freaking flask and flask of electrolytes. That sounded kind of like a flask of whiskey. No. And my music and light and, you know, the ability to press stop and play whenever I want. So we'll see. Just about repetition right now, over and over and over and over again. I'm kind of running through the set as much as I can. But that one feels pretty close. I have a couple of question marks for myself on that. Also, this line, this Charakeshi Express line. I don't know how familiar any of you are with Steve's music, but he's, some of it is kind of heavily steeped in a lot of Indian tradition, and I don't know what the technical terms for it. I always forget. I'm sorry, Steve, if you're listening, but it's super badass, first of all, and Steve knows it inside out, as does Vinny, who plays in the band, the guitar player Vinny Valentino, and of course now. Okay, here we go. It is opening. Spotify is opening. So there's, it's fast, and there's some unison stuff. There it is. I have to play that. Something like that. Something like that. A little loud here in the room. Damn, sorry. Sorry, people. Gotta find my in point here. It's getting close. I started off at around 80 BPM. I think this is sort of like 138, 140. It's getting close. It really is. It's not perfect. Okay, that was kind of good. So I started at 80 and I wound it up at 5 BPM every, I don't know, 5 minutes or something. I was working on it for about an hour. And something like that. Okay, so that's like the toughest line probably on the whole show, and then I got some unison stuff down here. All this stuff, this Indian solfège stuff, is super badass. Steve knows it inside out. I wish I'd paid more attention when I was hanging out with Prasanna and Kenwood and all these guys. Okay, that was the entrance. That was the start of the phrase. And the trouble is, I don't play from the top of the phrase. I kind of catch it. This is the middle of the sixth bar.
Yeah.
Okay, so it happens one time there, and then quite extensively. Oh, because we play the big line again. Right there, right there, right there. But it didn't diddle there. Woo! Ah, but where's the start point? Okay, so it's that little delay there, which throws a bit of a wrench in the works, but come on, I can get this. And I don't have the right page of music in front of me. What an idiot. I've got the start point. Okay, so you guys are getting the super super inside track on what's going on here, what I'm dealing with, and kind of how to put some of this stuff together and hopefully come out in the right place. There are a couple of things that are missing on certain stuff, so I'm gonna go through and kind of correct these charts, I think. Make a few fresh notes and then put them in the iPad. That's because a lot of these are just one pages. So that might be cool, just have them in the iPad. Little reference points. I'm trying to memorize it as much as possible. Pretty much Benny Greb's whole set is in the brain. I don't need too much music for that. Maybe a couple of little cheat sheets here and there, but most of it is in the brain, thankfully. But obviously this is all brand new. And brand new to me. And some of this stuff, I mean, this is an arrangement of rhythm and ing. So sloppy. Okay. haven't made that mistake in 2 days. That's the first time I've done that. Let's go again. Let's go again. Rhythm changes, but then Steve sent me an email. What did he say? There's a bass figure, or the bass and drums figure at the top of the guitar solo. Okay, I did hear this one time. Walk again. Okay, so it's just one time. So maybe I should write that down. And then the ending, I believe, okay, is the head and then the intro again. So let's try that. See, I'm trying to look, if you're watching on YouTube, I'm trying to look away from the music as much as possible because I'm in internalization mode right now. And yesterday was kind of learning the stuff, and I'm pretty close on that, I think. And now it's really about internalizing it. I wonder what. I wonder what else I should really work on here. Check out your open dialogue. Some of the stuff is not that difficult, which is cool. I might actually get some time to relax on this gig. some things. Well, it's good, actually. Like, there's me thinking, okay, I've played this one time before with Steve in Chicago last year. And I'm thinking, okay, this is an easier tune. Not complicated at all, walking, medium tempo, all of that stuff. But then there are some discrepancies in terms of the chart and what is actually happening. So I need to address that right away. Right there. Okay, so it stays on the one now. Okay, all right. So good to check in on the details, you know. Vamp out at the end is straightforward. There is a shout chord. Okay, see, these are things I'm starting to remember from yesterday from playing through the stuff for the first time. There's a shout chorus on this arrangement of Mr. PC. On the drum solo, so I should go over that. Here, maybe? Yep. Not the cleanest. Okay. Not so complicated, and then right at the end. Check the ending, see what's going on. Good. Okay, so I think Steve's stuff feels good, and now I'm working on the Grebster, the one and only German with the beanie, it's a beanie bearded German that I love so much. Okay, and I also have to remember where I put. Yeah, I label things so weird sometimes. This is Southeast Asia Songs 2018. Because that was the first time I played with Benny, and it was in Singapore and Thailand or something, and it was in 2018, and that is where I put all the MP3s that he sent me. So let's get cracking on his. Ooh la 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 la! What should we do? Tricky is, as the title would have you believe, kind of freaking tricky. Let's try it out. Oh yeah, I forget this little guitar intro thing. No count off, so I have to guess. I should look at which second. took too long of a breath. Thank you. also realize I'm kind of caning it unnecessarily. Maybe I won't use that lick. Hiccup in there, I think. I counted one hiccup, which is next question. I should probably use the OC2 on this. And that's in the wrong channel. Okay, I revamped a bunch. Okay, so let's edit that, and OC2 is now where? What a good question. Okay, OC2 looks like it's in number 2. Oops. Okay, loop structure, loop on and off, yes. Aha.
Here we have the problem.
And this one off, and right, and execute. Hello! The OC2 is back. Oh, I'm having some issues. I'm having some issues with volume on a couple of these channels. That really sucks. Okay, let's try and find a different place for it. Somewhere I'm going to remember it. So bank 3 is getting pretty full. How's 4 looking? Okay, it's going in 143. Again, what compelling TV, I hear you guys saying. Let's enter that patch. Let's learn to do this faster so people get bored less. Okay, there we go. Let's write that. Shit, now we got to call it. I wish there was a spit, like on the line 6 HX stomp. I wish there was a, what am I trying to say? A twisting knob. I have no English words for it right now, but just to select the characters rather than a button where you've got to scroll through the entire alphabet. Okay, element OP for octave. Let's go. We're going to do it all in caps because it's going to be quicker that way. Oh, OC2. Let's just go OC2. How about that? What a novel idea. Boom. OC2. Fantastic. Rather than putting octaver, although it's a Japanese OC2 black label, I would like to put octaver with the R on it. My vanity will have to wait. And then each channel before you program it comes preset where it says like boss and then a space and then ES5. Kind of wish it was blank, because then if you don't use any of those characters, you have to scrub them all out manually. All right, we're there. OC2 is executing. It's not that freaking loud, though. Let's see. Okay, that's not so bad. So where were we? Let's get back to the freaking song. God damn. Cheers. Right, do I have a little cheat sheet for this? Let me see, where's it going? Next question. Oh yeah, because it goes into 6-4. No problem. Those little details like that where he stops. You just don't want to be that guy playing through those rests. That's where the importance of playlists come in, and just being able to smash the thing on Spotify so many times. Do I really want that? Say I'm not ideally seated here with the pedals all off to the right, so the patch change becomes a little more complicated. But I think I want to play natural sound on the bridge and the octave sound on the verse. Yeah, we keep it like that. Oh yeah, and then we kind of go free and open. That's what I like about a lot of Benny's stuff, is we just like suddenly fall off a cliff and go wherever we go. Quite often to something unrelated. Oh, and then the drum solo. Yes, the ending. Mm-hmm. This will be visual cue. Yeah, speaking about being that guy playing through the gap. Let's try that again, shall we? Count the beats in the bar. This time sounds so ridiculous. Mine are pretty bad. 3 and bop 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 bop. Although I gotta say, in my defense, I'm probably not gonna be podcasting while I play this gig. Who knows? Is always a bit longer than I think it's than I think it is. Jesus Christ. Okay, that'll work. Strange ending. That's it. I love it. Two bars of A flat at the end. Cool. All right. September is all A flat. I've got that one down. Couscous. Why is my dog barking upstairs? Oh yeah, okay. This is pick time. Actually, where are my picks? Really disorganized here. Can I get it before the song kicks in? Let's see. That let's see. Ah, to get down. Okay, I'm so loud in the room. Definitely got a program a sound for this. I think that's the line. Let me double check because I did write it down. I lost the pick. Gong gong. Oh, it goes back up to D. Okay. Okay, let's go in on that section again. This is exactly what I'm talking about, going over the details, serving the song. Note so that I want to ask Benny if we can open that up a little bit at the end and improvise over those three chords. Okay, it's close, not perfect, but it's close, and by tomorrow it will be very, very cool. Let's see, twist. Boom, boom. Ah. Thank you. middle. I did not nail at all. What was that? Oh, it's 11. I can't read my own writing. Missing there. Ooh, what is it? Which one is it? Oh. Ooh. I think it's the second one there. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, exactly. Bam, 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 bam. Okay, cool. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, okay, okay. So 6, 5, 6, 5. Okay, good. Again, I should have really written some form down here. No idea what it does now. Thank you. just vamps out here, right? Okay. This is back when they were doing trio with the keyboards. Keyboard player was playing bass. Interesting. Okay. Woo! All right. We're almost an hour in here. I feel like I haven't scraped the surface. Oh. But this feeling, okay, let's talk about this for 2 seconds. This feeling of like feeling kind of a little bit behind, perhaps a little overwhelmed at times with the sheer volume of music. Obviously, I wasn't expecting to have to learn these other like 10 or 12 songs of Steve Smith at the last minute. So some stuff is complex, some stuff not so much. But maybe there's a little sense of being slightly overwhelmed when you're thinking about how much you want to do a good job. Like, I know I really want to do a good job for both artists, for myself, for the audience. You know, maybe this is the first time, for sure, this is the first time some of the audience is going to be hearing me or Benny or Steve for the first time. Maybe not live, but maybe not for the first time hearing us, but for the first time hearing us live, for sure. So that all those factors go into putting this together. But it's that feeling that crops up. It's good that that feeling crops up. That's what I'm trying to say. It's good that that feeling crops up now in my studio when I'm at home, in the practice room. La cuarta de práctica. Because then, you know, when I know that when I've done the work and when I've put in all of these hours, not that there were many hours to put in on Steve's stuff, unfortunately, but when I've done as much as I possibly can and I'm feeling pretty comfortable with it, that will translate in the performance on stage. So it's good sometimes for some doubt to creep in when you're working on this stuff. For me anyway, when I'm working on this stuff up front, it motivates me even more to do as good a job as I possibly can for these two really amazing drummers. What else we got here? Soul Food, next question. I guess Grebkistra is the one. I even made Grebkistra its own patch somewhere here. Where is that? Not on that bank. I should really know where it is as well. Holy shit. Is it there? No. Is it there? Yes. Okay. Sounds buzzy is what it sounds. Whoa. Sounds super buzzy. Okay. Why is that? Okay. There we go. There we go. Okay. That's the sound I want eventually. And I need this, as you will hear, I need this kind of chorus sound on the front. So let's do Grebkistra. Maybe I'll close out this episode of the podcast with that. And then I got to get to it, making my charts and stuff. Let's see. Yeah. Where are you, Benny? There we go. Oh, it goes up the octave. Ah. Thank you. Okay, so that transition is more about the feet right here to get from the chorus. And I can go do 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 do. What is that like? Do da da da. Is that what it is? Is that what it is? It's just B to C. Oh. My ears are starting to get fried. It's just okay. I don't know if I go to the big sound that soon. Ooh, it's a lot of hiss. Okay, let's see. Let's back it up just a little bit and try and get that transition. Benny goes. Like coming to the guitar solo, I think. Just rocking out, right? Hear that amount of hiss? Holy shit. It's just, I don't have the sound right yet. That's the problem with the overdrive. Now when I drive it, whoo, it's so bad. Crazy, yeah? Way too much high end. I gotta get the balance right there. That's one thing I'm working on for that song. But otherwise, that's coming together. Grebkistra, Notting Hill. Yeah. Definitely feeling a little better. And boy, I managed to play through a bunch of songs, which is cool. Again, the new Iron Ether pedal. So psyched about that. This video obviously was not all about that because there's too much stuff going on and it's not the place to be doing a full pedal demo. I don't even know really how to use it yet. So we'll get to that, I promise. Lots of pedal stuff coming, I got to say. Planning to do some stuff when I get back from Europe with Bob to do a whole series of bass player friendly pedal videos. There just doesn't seem to be enough out there for stuff I use, for instance. It's going to be quite a personal thing, but hopefully some knowledge as well. I love the JHS pedals channel, so I would love to do something on that level for bass. You know, there are plenty of crazy pedals that I have back here. I did a pedal inventory the other day, somewhere like towards the 170 mark number of pedals that I have right now, and just checking out cool stuff that I forgot I had and I want to get more into and explain a little bit and make good examples and do high quality sound, beautiful video, and just make some nice stuff. That's it. People of the bass world, don't forget practice room. Look at this, a little cold this evening here in LA, so I'm wearing a hoodie. Practice room hoodies available below. Book of the month is 251 Jazz Vocabulary for Electric Bass. It is half price all of February 2020. Anything else to report? I don't know. There's a brand new episode of Two Bass Hit, our Monday, weekly Monday podcast, mine and Chelsea's podcast. That is up and running on the channel also, so check that out. Don't forget to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. Give the channel a thumbs up if you dig what you're seeing. And if you're listening online, don't forget to head over to the YouTube channel and leave your comments and your feedback. Always nice. No, I tell you, you guys are amazing. It's 99.8% of the time the comments are so fun to read and funny, and you guys have amazing sense of humor, and I love it. I love it. There are a few knuckleheads out there, but there always are. So we shall let them be knuckleheads and carry on being bass players. So ladies and gentlemen of the bass world, thank you for spending a little bit of your time, a little bit of your day with me, and see you all on the next one.